Thank you for watching Industrial TV. We're going to do Overwatch Origins Edition, the free play days for Xbox One. And I'm just going to do a quick review on it because I've never actually played this game, but I'm not too big on MOBAs, but obviously this is like a first-person shooter MOBA. So let's check it out. I'm going to do a little I'm going to play it a little bit, and then I'll do a review at the end real quick. So let's check it out. Of course, this is very Borderlands looking. I know the people of Borderlands made their own version of this game, but yeah.
Hello, Soldier 76. I am Athena. I will be guiding you through the Overwatch training program. Now, where is she?
Wait for me! Hiya! Tracer here!
Let's get started. Please use your controls to look at Tracer as she moves around the room.
Over here!
Excellent. Now watch Tracer run to the center of the room. Let's go over the basics of movement. Follow Tracer as she moves around the hangar. Continue following Tracer. Keep following Tracer. Excellent. Jump up onto the ledge and go through the blast door. Welcome to the target range. Please proceed to the highlighted area. Let me walk you through the basics of combat. Your portrait is displayed in the lower left corner of your screen. That's you, Soldier 76. Next to it is your current health. If it reaches zero, you die. Your primary weapon is your heavy pulse rifle. I'll get you something to shoot at. Aim through the crosshairs in the middle of your screen. Open over the training box, then fire. Nicely done. You can also strike a target near you with a melee attack. Move next to the training bot, aim, then strike it with a melee attack. Enemies in the field may be a little harder to hit than that one. Let me get you something a little more challenging to shoot. Enemies like these training bots are marked with a red outline. Nice shooting. Damaging an enemy causes their current health displayed above their head. Most weapons fire a limited amount of ammo before they need to be reloaded. There is one bot remaining. Great work. That covers the basics of your weapon. Next, we'll go over your abilities. We'll begin with sprint. While moving forward, you can activate sprint to run faster. Try it now. In addition to sprint, you also have the ability to heal yourself with biotic field. To demonstrate it, I need to damage you slightly. Now, Deploy a biotic field. You will heal while you're within the glowing area. Note that you will have to wait a short time before using that ability again. This cooldown time is displayed over the ability icon. Completely, you can launch a volley of rockets in the direction you're aiming. When the rockets explode, they also damage nearby enemies. Try it out on the targets. Fire your helix rockets at the targets. Finally, let me explain Tactical Visor, your ultimate ability. These powerful abilities can change the course of a game, but you must fully charge it before using it. Your current charge level is displayed here, at the bottom of your screen. Charge your Tactical Visor by damaging the training bots. Dealing damage will charge your ultimate. Your ultimate is 50% charged. Your ultimate is almost fully charged. The tactical visor is charged. The tactical visor optimizes your shots so they do not miss. Now, activate your tactical visor and
I've
destroy
got you in my sights. Clean sweep.
Targets destroyed. Nice work, Soldier 76.
Well, that's kind of cool, the tactical visor thing. That's kind of neat.
I'll show you how to capture an objective. Your current objective is indicated with the directional marker labeled A. The objective is marked with a bright outline on the ground. While you are within the area, you make progress towards capturing the objective. Your current progress is displayed here on your screen. If there are enemies in the area with you, capture progress is paused. You have successfully captured the objective. You can now try a practice game versus AI, replay the tutorial, or face off against other players.
Ooh, I kind of like this guy, Reaper. Of course, a lot of these characters, obviously. Let's just play. Let's play this shit. Quick play. Just do a quick play. Really, I have to do this. Like, this is so stupid.
Arriving at
a shooter's a shooter's a shooter.
Stabilized.
traveling to Route 66. Prepare to attack.
Death walks among you.
Right. This is where I picked up the damn ingrate.
We shall prove ourselves in glorious combat!
Attack commences in 30 seconds.
Good, wrap that up in a butter blunt. I mean, whatever you're smoking it in, it's obviously not good for your lungs. Yeah, keep them, make your cough.
Back in my day, we have this payload delivered already.
I and I ganja fama. I gotta fucking stab pretty quickly. I like how this guy just drops his guns when he's done with them. Kinda cool.
Thank you.
not strong enough. I'm not even close to done.
Ready player kill streak.
Job well done.
So what's in a loot box? I'm sure it's probably just, who knows? Really, this is a MOBA, so it could be anything. For all those who don't know what a MOBA is, it's basically just a game where you really don't like customize your character too well. You know what I'm saying? It's just, that's exactly what it is. It's like a MOBA with preset shit. Obviously they got new skins and stuff like that. Voice line.
I'll send you my consultation fee. Leave this to a professional.
So, there we go. See if we can play now. Quick play. This shit is so fucking buggy. I have to do practice range. Really?
Welcome to the practice range, Soldier 76. This is a place where you can experiment with your weapons and abilities. In the practice range, you can change your hero here. On other maps, you can only change your hero in the room where you enter the match or rooms where you reappear after dying. Bring up the hero select screen to view all available characters. Let's try switching to a different... When you have a hero selected, you can view details about them by pressing the information button. When you are ready, please close this window to continue. Now confirm your select... Once you have selected a hero, you can view their information at any time. Feel free to explore the practice range. I encourage you to come back here anytime you want to experiment your skills. When you are finished, you can leave the practice range at any time.
Yeah!
So this guy basically shoots two little shotguns. That's the way you want to look at it. He's got two little handguns. It's a close ranger. Which is fine, because a lot of people run up on you. See if we can find you a quick play. Yes. All right, let's do this.
Traveling to Mumbai.
Oh, an African planet. Awesome. Numbani. Numbani.
Justice ain't gonna dispense itself.
Enough waiting around.
Oh, excuse me. Oh, that'll do fine.
Attack commences in 30 seconds.
I'm not one for standing around. This one's mine.
Regrettable, but necessary.
Get the fuck back.
Yes.
malfunctioning.
Talon strikes.
The payload has reached the checkpoint.
From the shadows.
People got shitty, I know they did.
Checking in.
Reinhardt at your service.
Zenyatta is here.
Justice reigns from above.
Reporting.
The payload is mine.
Tracer here.
Deja vu.
For a different outcome.
Okay, so that's my quick review. What am I going to say? You know, like, obviously this isn't the full game, but it's like what I expected it to be. Each character is exactly, is meant for a specific reason. You got your tanking characters, you got your that guy that blocks everything, you got a healing character, you got up close rangers, you got long rangers. And there's not much more to it. Like, you, there's no, I mean, as far as I know, I don't think there's any upgrading. I think you can upgrade a little bit later on, or as you play your tune and shit. Obviously, they're gonna give you something to work for. But other than that, it's a MOBA. It's a first-person shooter MOBA. So if you like MOBAs and you like first-person shooters, check it out. Thanks for watching Deathshroud TV, and if you like what you saw, please hit that follow button, and I also do take requests on reviews and just gameplay.